Hi, so I'm out today, and as you can see, I'm riding the Kommoda today. So what we're doing, it's a little bit of a review because essentially I use this bike for some very different trips. So today, we're going to be going to a different place than I normally do. It's a bit quieter, and we're gonna have something to eat and make some music. See you in a bit. Right, so yeah, as I said, today I'm out on the Kommoda. This is a restricted road legal version of the bike. However, I do have a throttle on there. Obviously these aren't road legal. But then I don't use it on the road either, so I only really ever use the throttle if I'm off-road, to be honest, on this bike. But yeah, we're going to do something a little bit different. So at the moment we're just sort of going along by the Hive Canal in Hive, obviously, down in southeast Kent. I've got the Portland Zoo over on the right hand side. Occasionally you can see some animals in there. Looks like there's some people in there today though. Maybe they're different types of animals. But yeah, anyway, so I use the Kommoda to do a few different things, basically. So because of its the bike comes with a rear rack, then generally I use this bike when I need to take a bit more stuff with me, which is the case today, because it's only a day trip out, not a camping one. But yeah, we're going to take the bike to a really quiet spot, hopefully, where hardly anybody comes along, to be honest. I'm going to have a barbecue and I'm going to write some music. So, well, hopefully I'm going to write some music anyway, but yeah, I kind of like coming out on the Kommoda, going to a nice spot, nice scenery, and it really does inspire me to sort of be a little bit creative, hopefully. But yeah, we'll see. Anyway. Let's get on with our journey. And we'll catch up in a bit. Now, what can we tell you about the Kommoda? Well, it's a step-free e-bike from Cyrusher. Very similar to the Obia, which is a later model. With a few sort of upgraded parts to the Kommoda, really. Slightly different placement for the battery on the Obia, but yeah, they're very comparable bikes, really. The Obia is probably a bit more comfortable, further range because it's got a larger battery, etc. But anyway, enough about the Obia. Let's talk about the Kommoda. Well, we've got Zoom hydraulic disc brakes, left and right, front and back rather. We've got a light on the front. We've also got a light on the back, and also a brake light as well. So for added safety, etc. We've got a horn, or beep rather. Then obviously I've got my throttle on here. It's a thumb throttle. Now, I really don't like thumb throttles personally. I don't feel like you've got the same kind of control over that as you have with a half twist throttle. But you know. Then we've got our computer controls up and down for selecting your pedal assist modes. I'm currently in pedal assist 5. Why? I've got loads of battery, and it's a really, really hot day. To be honest, it's the very last day of summer, I think, in the UK here, because after today, looking at the weather report, it looks like we've got gale force winds and rain every single day. So yeah, welcome to the UK summer that barely lasts any time at all. So the Kingfisher display in the centre, perfectly adequate. However, I wish they'd do something, because yes, you can see that when you're in the shade, but sometimes when you're in direct sunlight, you won't see that. The sun will glare off of that screen, and it's impossible for me to read. So to be honest with you, I don't seem to get that problem so much with the Ranger display, with that being colour as well. But as nice as colour is, the monochrome displays are by far the easiest to read in any kind of condition. You know, super sunny, I can read a monochrome display really easily. Yeah, I don't know what it is with a Kingfisher display. It's, yeah, as soon as a bit of sun glares on there, it's gone for me. Not that I need to, you know, constantly look at it, but it is a, you know, it's a good indication thing. Thank you. Right, so, what else have we got here? So, we got 9-speed gear selector, the Shimano's, over here. So you got your up and your down selector. Obviously, as I said, you've got your brakes and your handle grips. On the front, we've got the motor-style front forks, fully adjustable, with a, you know, lock-in, lock-out mechanism as well, if you so wished. Thank you. And right, so down on the frame, hidden inside the frame, down here, I don't know if you can see it, but there's a 17 amp hour battery in there, 48 volt 17 amp hour battery. Oh, that's where all the mud has dried up. Well, thankfully the mud's all dried up, but come next week again, this place will be a mud bath, no doubt. It won't look very nice. Thank you. Thank you. But yeah, as I said, 17 amp hour battery in the middle. You can charge it on or off the bike, so not a problem. Wherever you want to charge it. Takes 5 to 6 hours for a full charge, from, you know, from run right down. So yeah, okay, so that's the battery. Also, there's a charging port on the frame at the bottom there. So if you do want to charge the bike on, charge the battery on the bike, then you're able to do that, because there's a charging port on there. Thank you. And to be honest with you, the Kommoda is a really nice bike. I'm 6'2", but you know, I did a review before of this bike, and I would, you know, anyone 5 foot nothing, you'd be able to fit on this bike, no problem, step through. The seat should go, well, goes down far enough, I think, for anybody of 5 foot. So that shouldn't be a problem for those people. Right, let's continue on. Because not so many people come down as far as this way. Or carry on down here, should I say. Right, what else have we got on the Kommoda? So, what else have we got? Okay, I've mentioned the brakes. We got 20-inch wheel rims. So obviously with the fat tyres on there, you're looking at about 23-inch. There's a kickstand on the bike, obviously, as with all, you know, fat tyre e-bikes, they generally have a kickstand, just because of the weight of them, you know. And to be honest, it's a welcome addition. You know, you want your bike upright in a lot of situations, you know. So this bike, the Kommoda, it's got a 750 watt motor on the back. But, right, so Cyrusher, they're really good. They deliver the bike in a road legal format. So it's restricted down to 250, oh, pardon me. It's restricted down to 250 watts and has a max speed of 15 miles an hour, or sorry, 15.5 miles per hour. So the bike comes with a rear rack and fenders as standard, which is all very good as well. Right, so, I've come to a point now where I need to be strong, because I've got to lift this bike over this turnstile here, because yeah, unfortunately they don't seem to want to make this route accessible, even though, you know, it's not like it's private land or anything, but there we go. Anyway, I'm going to lift this bike. There we are. That's 34 kilos with the battery included. That's a standard bike weight. Right, so try as I might, I literally cannot get this bike over that turnstile. I'm actually worn out. So I'm gonna have to go back down this path, and then we'll go out onto the road, and then we need to go quite a distance along here to get back to where we want to be, essentially. So that's what we're going to do. Man, I'm worn out. But yeah, that was pretty much an impossibility to get that bike over there on my own. There's no way in the world that's happening. Oh, there's plenty of cows about. In fact, oh, what have we got here? We have a cow. I hope that's not a bull. I hope he's not going to charge us. Afternoon, Mr. Cow. There we are. I believe this is the place. Where I wanted to come. Whew. Well, it is indeed. Right, so I've got all my music equipment set up, which is all down here. So I've got brought my little MacBook Pro, a tiny little synth that you can see there. I've got my barbecue ready to go and everything else. So while we're doing that, let's just take a quick look over the Kommoda. All right, so as I said, got these nice grips. They're fairly adequate, fairly nice. We've got a light and a horn button. I've installed the accelerator here, the throttle, and we've got our up and down computer buttons there, the Kingfisher display. So we've got our gear shifters, and behind these we've got our zoom brakes, etc. We've got these motor style front forks at the front, which has all your adjustments and lock in, lock out. A nice bright 250 lumen light on the front. Front fenders, 23 inch wheels, front and back, moving round. We've got the battery compartment here. There's the key, which you can lock in or lock out. That's up to you. We've got a charge port here, so if you want to charge the battery on the bike, you can do so there. What have we got? So moving around, we've got our rear shock. This is just a spring-loaded shock, and I really, really wish Cyrusher would just do away with these, to be honest. They're adequate, don't get me wrong, they're absolutely fine, but I would sort of suggest to a lot of people to just swap these out for an air shock. You can pick one up for about £90, to be honest with you, and they make the whole world of difference. Moving down, obviously we've got your pedals. These pedals also, but yeah, I can't do it with one hand, but essentially these pedals, they fold flat, as you can see, if storage space is tight, and then when you want to go out for your ride, you just pull them out and they lock into place. But yeah, I can't do that with one hand and hold the camera. Okay, so obviously you've got all this rear acts on your rear suspension. As that goes down, you've got your 750 watt hub motor, which is restricted, as I said, to 250 watts to conform with the UK law. And this bike is in its restricted state, not in an unrestricted state. So 15.5 miles an hour is my top speed. We've got 160 millimeter disc brakes, both front and back, as you can see there, and on zoom, hydraulic brakes are there as well. Okay, so obviously the bike comes with a rear fender already attached and the rear rack, which is capable of holding up to 25 kilos on that rear rack. So just be aware when you're loading up the bike. Maximum payload for the bike is 150 kilograms. So that's taking into consideration your weight and anything that you may be carrying, either on your back or on this rear rack. So just be aware, that's a total of 150 kilograms. The seat's fairly comfortable. It's not going to win any awards, but it's it's fairly comfortable. Move around the back, and we've got our light, our rear light. And oh look, I still haven't taken look at how shinier that looks now. This acts as a rear light. And also, when you pull the brake lever, that will also light up as well. Right, let's move around this side. Get rid of some of that grass out of my derailleur, because that probably won't help. But yes, you've got your rear derailleur, 9-speed gears on this. You don't really need any more on an electric bike, to be honest with you. All those people complaining and saying, oh, I want 21 speeds. You're just not going to use them on an electric bike. And they're just pointless, to be honest with you. On an ordinary bike, you really do need those gears. And they come into play a lot. On an electric bike, no. You know, anything past 9 is a waste, really, in my opinion. But there we go. But yeah, absolutely beautiful bike. You know, highly recommend it. You know, if you're if this kind of bike fits your the thing that you want from a bike, and this particular style, then I'd highly recommend it. It's absolutely beautiful. Oh, a bit of cobwebs and other rubbish on there. But yeah, absolutely beautiful bike, to be honest with you. Right, so right, now we've done all that, I'm gonna start my Barbie, get the Barbie on, hopefully get some inspiration and start writing some music. And we'll come back to this all in a bit later. It's in a bit. Right, so our barbecue has looks like no more flames are coming out of that. Right, so it's time to put on our kebabs that I made earlier. Now, if I was out on a camping trip, I'd just bring all the raw ingredients out. I'd bring an axe, a saw, we'd make our own fire, but today I'm cheating. I brought a disposable barbecue with us, just to save a bit of time, really. So I've made these kebabs at home. Oh, don't they look lovely? So what have we got on there? We've got pork, we've got pepper, we've got onions, tomatoes, and mushrooms. And I've doused them in stir fry oil and a bit of basil as well, hopefully that'll bring out all the flavours. Oh, there we go, now we're cooking. Right, we'll let that cook. And I'm gonna switch on my computer and get inspirational. Well, I'm definitely feeling inspired. I brought a couple of samples with me. Ricky Lake Some of you might know her. I just stole a little bit of an interview that that she was being part of, and I've started to make a tune with it, so I'm feeling relatively happy about that. So right now my kebabs are still cooking, so I feel it must be time to open up a cider. Oh, probably got bounced around a bit on the bike, but there we go. This one's a very low alcohol one, so hold off for the comments of drinking and riding at the same time. It's one cider, and I'm intending to be here for a little while yet, so cheers. Right, so my kebabs are ready. I've just taken the first two off, and I'm going to enjoy them with my cider. Music's going well. Hopefully, should get something pretty much done today, to be honest with you, because it's my inspiration seems to be flowing, as they say. But yeah, so anyway, I'm going to enjoy my grub. Enjoy my cider. Oh, it's so lovely. Coming out on the bike. Beautiful little spot. Great bit of food. What's not to like? Right, so I finished eating. I still have a little bit of cider left though, so it's a proper nice grub. But yeah, so I'm gonna continue on with my music. Probably stay here for a few more hours yet, so I'll catch you in a bit. Right, so I've been out here for about 4 hours now, thoroughly fed and watered. Inspiration came thick and fast. I'm all packed up now anyway, so what I'll do is I'll pop the music up on the post edit of the video, so that you can have a listen to it. Yeah, quite happy actually. And all made possible because the Kommoda brought me out here, and she really is a beautiful bike. So yeah, if you're in the market for a step free bike, highly recommend it. Right, so I just need to pack up my last few bits and pieces and we'll head home. I'll put the GoPro on, and yeah, as I said, I'll put the music I wrote in the on the ride home, on the post edit, etc. Right, thanks for watching. Catch you soon.
What did you play when you were a kid? And who did you play with?
Well, we moved a lot. I'm thinking of now, when you asked me that at this time, about 64, 65. And I had a couple of friends at school, usually boys, a couple of boys. And I think most of the time we made up games. We'd climb trees and make up dance routines or shows or stuff. I don't know, we made up games. Mostly, I think I played horses, now that I think of it. I'd be a horse, and I'd run through the fields making horse sounds. I'd be a horse, and I'd run through the fields making horse sounds. I'd be a horse.